Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the best of deceiver. The best of deceivers, that means he would not guide those people like you who are enemy of him to his way and save them, but he will let them and their deceive their bad intention and bad wicked soul till they die, then he will put them to be toasted. Sam, you will be toasted, roasted, and burned in hell. Like you and all the swans.
Yeah. Guys, thank him. He just admit Allah is the best of all deceivers. And what's ironic, he still hasn't been able to refute the fact Allah deceived the followers of Jesus into thinking Jesus died. They were convinced that he died. Then they were convinced he was raised physically, went to heaven to reign as Lord of Lords and King of Kings, and started worshiping him and preached that message. So that message is still dominant over against Islam, all because of Allah deceiving them into believing a lie. And he wants me to follow this God that makes Satan look humble and honest in comparison. You can keep your God. We will worship Jesus, the Son of God, Muhammad's God, judge and destroyer.
Why would Allah create Christianity by making the illusion of a crucifixion and enabling all those poor, misguided early Christians to believe they'd seen a man risen?
Let me answer that one real quick. I mean, this is a question you need to ask Muslims. Throw it to them. Why would Allah, if he's such a great God, if you believe he's in control of everything, why in the world would he have created Christianity? And why in the world would he have allowed another man to die in Jesus's place, take the image, put it on another man, then not telling anybody for 600 years. And then 600 years later, after there were millions of Christians all over the world, not only does that show that the God of the Quran is duplicitous, is deceitful,
the best of plotters,
is immoral. And what in the world is he doing creating a religion that stands in direct contradiction to everything he is trying to put? That's a huge question. And I'm glad I don't have to answer that question. But you throw that question at Muslims and see how they answer it.
You pointed out that Allah in the Quran, am I correct in this, is actually a deceiver, that he has the attributes of Satan himself?
Well, the 99 names of Allah are very well known in Islam.
Yeah.
Some of these names, if you look at them, one of the names of Allah in the Quran is Al-Mutakabbir, which means the most proud one. Mm. When I read the Bible as a Muslim, and I saw the most proud one in the Bible was Satan, or Al-Mumit, the one who causes death.
Well, exactly. Well, you know, I'm just writing a book. I've just finished one on humility. And the truth is the root sin of the world is pride. Yeah, I will exalt myself upon the throne of God.
And that's the problem, where Muslims cannot see the truth from the Bible.
But the one that they say is Allah is the most proud one.
The most. We say Al-Mutakabbir.
Yeah.
It's the El, like the Elohim.
Yeah, yeah.
El is the most proud one. So the most proud one is Allah.
But that's really Satan.
Exactly. And it's worse than that, because he's the one who causes death, Al-Mumit,
yeah.
Al-Makir, the great deceiver.
Yes.
This is the names of Allah in the Quran. So
they really believe the great deceiver?
Yes.
I mean, in America, we don't hear this.
Yes. In the Quran, it says, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. You know, Allah is the greatest of all deceivers. So it is okay. That's why Islam has deception in war. Mm-hmm. That's why Islam offers hudna, or a peace treaty, to non-Muslims up to 10 years, but they must break the peace treaty somewhere.
Well, the hudna was Oslo. In other words,
you Americans called it the Oslo Peace Accord.
Yeah.
We called it the Oslo Hudna Accord.
Hudna.
So a hudna is a treaty. It's actually not a peace treaty. It's a ceasefire. In Islam, we're allowed to have a ceasefire for two reasons. First, reason number one, to gain concessions.
Yes.
Reason number two, to deceive the enemy and destroy them in the end.
What about the Bush administration, Condoleezza Rice? Bush comes out and says this is a religion of peace. Condoleezza Rice has a celebration at the end of Ramadan and honors these people on account of this great religion. Are they deceived?
It's a deception. I mean, CARE, Council of American Islamic Relations, they say we condemn terrorism. We condemn terrorism. Mm. Well, what we need to do as Americans is to say, wait a minute, condemning a terrorism is not a verb, it's an act.
In chapter 3 of the Quran, verse 54, it says that he is the best of all deceivers, the best of all schemers, the best of all connivers. The Arabic phrase is khayrul makirin. Mm-hmm. That word, makir, if you look at any Arabic lexical source, means someone who is a shyster, a conniver, mm-hmm. a trickster, a deceiver. There is no way that a Christian could ever say of his God that his God is the best of all deceivers. Because according to the Bible, that's a description of Satan, not the God revealed in the person of Jesus Christ. Therefore, for Allah to say that he's the best of all deceivers, that means that the Allah of Muhammad is actually Satan in disguise. Because the Bible says Satan is the one who deceives the whole world, mm-hmm. not the God revealed in Jesus Christ.
Thank you.